Hey everybody, I'm Zach.
And I'm Jesse.
And you're watching In Depth
on Now You Know.
And this week we are not out of our depth because we went to LA to the semi-truck unveiling, and it was more than just a semi-truck.
Yes, we saw the semi-truck and we were very impressed. And then out of the back of the semi-truck, just like we had, I think we had said this in one of our past videos.
Yeah.
Please someone go back and find like the timestamp of one of our past videos where we guessed where this would happen. The Roadster comes out.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Driven by Franz von Holzhausen himself.
Yes. Now, before we get ahead of ourselves, you may have noticed that we're wearing these very attractive looking,
very stylish
Electrek sweatshirts. We're not sponsored by Electrek or anything.
No.
We just happened to bump into Fred Lambert and the team at from Electrek. It's a wonderful, wonderful news website.
The best crew. They work so hard to bring us information about everything that's going on in sustainable vehicles. Mm-hmm. You guys are amazing.
Yeah. And hey, you know what? So do we. So you guys rock. Thank you so much for the sweatshirts. Love wearing them. They're very comfortable. And yeah, just it's great to have such a good community.
It really is.
Around this. So
That's one thing I really loved about the other night was that you're in a room with like 1,000 people who all believe in what we're doing.
Right. Yeah.
And we're all physically there together.
It was fantastic.
All right, let's get to it. There's two basically big pieces here. The first is the Tesla semi truck.
Yes.
We are going to give you in this in depth kind of our feelings about what's culturally going to change now that this has been unveiled.
Mm-hmm. And also the Roadster.
Yes.
So let's start with the truck. I think the first thing, the biggest thing for me was that when the trucks pulled in, is that it sounded like nothing. They were just dead silent.
Yes.
And throughout the whole night, they were driving back and forth to give people test rides. And
it was the most eerie thing because you're used to seeing a truck and hearing and smelling it. All three things. Right, and feeling it.
Yeah, even when it's not moving. It's an idle.
It was like it was a movie screen over to the right.
It was as if it wasn't there. I mean, it was. I touched it.
Right. I was in it.
Yeah. So cool.
Yeah.
I mean, it made no noise. It emitted no noise, no sound, no pollution.
No snow. Yeah.
Nothing.
And you know what's interesting is that Elon, when talking about the truck, talked about all of its cool stats about its battery and its range. He didn't really mention anything about the fact that they are non-emitting, no pollution.
Right.
Why didn't he do that?
I think because literally, like, we were in one section over to the right, and then over to the left were all the big trucking companies and the people who were responsible for buying trucks. And so if
he would have pissed them off?
I think so. I think, you know, if you're selling a product to somebody, you can't be like, you suck. Your stuff has been polluting the world forever. We hate you. And by the way, here's our truck that's way better than yours because of the reasons why you suck.
I agree with you, and I'm sure that's why they did it. But I think it would have been cool to have also sold it on the selling points of if you buy this truck, you can tell all of your customers, you know, say you're Walmart, you can tell all your customers we get all of your goods to the stores without emitting any pollution.
Right. I think that, that would have been powerful, but I don't think Tesla's in the place where they can push that.
Now let's talk about what probably happened either that night or the next morning as many people woke up in different industries. So if you were in the trucking industry, if you're working for a big company like Daimler or, you know, Cummins Engines or one of those big companies,
oh crap. Because here's what the news was for months. The news was that Tesla's gonna come out with a truck. It was gonna be about 200 mile range, 200 to 300 miles, and that was good. But it was not exciting.
Yeah, so there's basically a 300-mile range truck and a 500-mile range truck. And as Elon pointed out, I think it's 85% of trips are fit within that range.
Right. And so you can, for a lot of the time, go to and from a place. And this is with fully loaded.
Right, fully loaded. I mean, 80,000 pounds.
Right, so if you're Daimler or another trucking, you know, a company that produces trucks, you're going, oh, crap.
Right.
And here's the other reason why. The pricing of the trucks is cheaper.
So explain this to me. So the truck itself is going to cost somewhere around $250,000.
Right.
Now, which that's more than a regular diesel truck.
Right. But running it, the everyday, first of all, 1,000,000-mile warranty on the drivetrain.
Unbelievable.
That's fantastic because when a truck breaks down, it's not fun.
Yeah, and one little thing that Elon just mentioned kind of off the cuff is this truck will tell you before it needs the maintenance that it's going to need the maintenance.
Right. It doesn't just break down on the side of the road and now you need a repair truck to come to you. You could just go to a repair station because you know it's coming up.
Also, brakes. Right. He mentioned that basically brakes are no longer an issue.
Right.
Because it's using the motors to do most of the braking.
Right. So, I mean, if you're a trucking company, and let's get back to the price.
Oh,
the
yes.
price is significantly less. A normal diesel truck costs about $1.51 per mile.
Wow.
And they said with the Tesla truck, it'll be $1.26 per mile.
Wow, that's already a huge savings.
It's a huge savings. But then they said with if you put them in a convoy that is backed, you know, having them follow each other very closely, which you can do with autopilot, you can get that cost down to 85 cents per mile. So it's about 50% less.
Wow.
And that is most of the cost of trucking, is literally your fuel and maintenance. And so taking care of those two things means that you're bringing the cost down, which is just astounding.
The other thing that I think a lot of trucking companies thought was, well, Tesla will come up their truck, but there won't be any way to charge it fast. So,
right.
It won't work.
Mega chargers. Dude, these things are going to be pumping out just megawatts of electricity.
Yeah. We estimate 1.6 megawatts of electricity.
That's
so that means that intense. You can charge about 400 miles, according to Elon, in about half an hour.
Right.
And that's after you've driven for many hours. And by law, in most places, you have to stop anyway and take a break.
Right. One thing that I didn't know was to fill a semi-truck full of diesel takes about 15 minutes.
Right.
So, I mean, you're just, it's about the same, it takes about the same amount of time for you to fill up your truck and then go in and grab a pretzel or something and then come back out.
Exactly. You know? And I mean, probably while you're getting it filled, I don't know, tell me this, truck drivers out there, when you're getting your diesel truck filled, do you have to be standing by the truck or can you be eating lunch?
Right.
Because with the Tesla semi, you will be able to go have lunch.
Right.
You'll be able to check on your phone when your truck is
right,
ready.
It'll have an app. I mean, how amazing is that?
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
Also, they designed the truck from the ground up as if they were saying, hey, if we were to start from scratch, what would we do? They put the driver in the middle.
It makes so much sense. Why would you be on the left-hand side of the truck?
Right.
And, oh my, the visibility out of the front, there's no nose. There's no engine here. It's, you know, you're looking out the front. It's just a panorama of what's going on around you.
Now, we have gotten some comments from truck drivers who said that without the proper mirrors, you can't back up a truck. You can't do it with cameras alone. I got to question that because I think if you've ever seen how good it is in the back of a, let's say, a Model X with the camera, and that's just one little camera, that if you have multiple cameras and you have all these cool screens in front of you, I think you're going to, and sensors and so forth,
yeah.
I think you're going to be able to back that thing up way easier than just a couple mirrors because mirrors are just single points.
That's true. Yeah, I mean, obviously, if you put a mirror in the same place, I mean, if you put a camera in the same place as a mirror, it's the same thing, so.
And then enhanced autopilot. I mean, this is going to make trucks so much safer. It's just, it's all game changing.
Right.
I mean, these people are waking up. So this is the trucking company we're talking about waking up the next morning. What about people waking up in the train industry?
Right. Well, and we were talking about trucking companies from the perspective of someone who's the people who are building the trucks. But if you are a trucker or in a small trucking company, you should be thinking about this truck.
Yeah.
I mean, wowie, wow, wow. Just the acceleration alone means that you're going from something that sucks to drive to something that I think is going to be fun to drive. I mean, the acceleration is just mind-bogglingly more.
I mean, to go from 0 to 60 in 5 seconds.
It feels great. And you're in a semi-truck doing that? That's killer.
That's Model 3 speeds.
Right. I mean, obviously that's without the trailer. With the trailer, it takes 20 seconds.
Right, but that's compared to a minute.
Right. That's crazy good.
One third the time.
Yeah, you're getting on the highway, 20 seconds is not that long.
No.
I mean, you're up to highway speeds in no time.
It's a game changer in so many ways.
It's a game changer, yeah.
Safety. Fuel efficiency, emissions, I mean, you name it. Whatever metric you can come up with, they blew it out of the water.
Yeah.
Now, that happened, and I thought at the end of his speech, like, my brain was just, oh my God, so many things.
It's so good.
And but then I got to be honest, because he had hyped it so much with mind blowing out of your head, I thought, well, my mind's not really out of my head. It's still in my head.
Yeah.
But then this happened. Franz was in the back of the truck.
The whole time. It was like a Scooby-Doo episode. Like, he was in the back of the truck the whole time. Like, oh, it was Franz the whole time. So he pulls out in the most beautiful car I've ever seen.
We couldn't stop screaming.
Yeah.
Our heads off.
I mean, and I thought that it was just going to be like, you know, a rolling prototype. You know, like one of those just boxes on wheels.
Right.
And then he just
screamed off.
And then he gave us the countdown, 3, 2, 1.
Yep.
And he was gone.
He was gone.
Oh my gosh.
I'd never seen anything move that fast before. And it didn't
compute
silently.
For me. Yeah.
No. And so then what happened was Elon said, hey, everybody, just push the barriers aside.
So he gave us the stats, which were fantastic. If you haven't heard them yet, welcome to the world. 0 to 60 in 1.9 seconds.
Yeah.
0 to 100 in 4.2. 620 miles of range? What?
What are you talking about? I mean, 200 kilowatt hour battery?
Yeah. In a sports car.
Yeah.
Your supercar does not do it justice. This is a hypercar. This is like...
Yes.
This is going to put, Bugatti and Koenigsegg out of business.
But get the price. For the Founder Series, we're talking $250,000.
For the base model, which is with the stats that I just listed, the Founder Series is going to be better. The base model is going to be $200,000. Which
for a hypercar.
For a hypercar. You can
a four-seater.
Yeah. You can outrun a Bugatti. I mean, what?
You can outrun anything.
I mean, police departments are going to need to get these just so they can enforce the law.
And here's the thing. I mean, you may not believe Elon, but I sat in it.
Right.
And it actually did it.
And I mean, we have footage of it.
And I filmed it for you guys.
Yeah. So this I think is arguably bigger than the semi-truck. Obviously not physically, but culturally, this is going to change the world. Basically what happened was they rolled out this car and it basically neuters every gas car.
No, I agree.
It completely, like, what are you going to drive that's going to outperform this?
Right.
A Formula One car? You can't drive that to work. You could drive this thing to work. I mean, it's bananas. And the thing is, it's going to be the car that's on the poster that hangs in the little kid's room.
True.
You know? Everyone is going to have posters of these cars. Let's be real.
Yeah.
And it's going to be the Lamborghini, the Porsche, the Ferrari, the things that we were like, oh wow, what a beautiful, amazing car, you know, beautiful in the design and amazing in the performance.
Mm-hmm.
This it's going to, you know, before the first Roadster, no one thought that electric cars could be anything more than a golf cart.
No, it was a game changer.
So the first Roadster came out, people were like, wow, it's a acceptable sports car. Right? And then the Model S comes out and then it gets better and better until it's outperforming many, many cars.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, this is only 0.2 seconds faster.
True.
You know, it's marginally better, but still better than everything else out there. This is literally the next generation. The 620 miles of range is the next generation. It's something that, you know, it's just a no-brainer. So what this means is that people are going to be aspiring to this car, and I understand. I definitely could not afford a Roadster, although we're going to get one through our referrals, so thank you, people who use our referral code. You made our complete week.
Yeah.
But it means that when you're going out and looking to buy a car, mm-hmm. and you say, maybe I'll get an electric car, because it's like the Tesla Roadster.
I see. Yeah, it's
building acceptance. I mean, mm-hmm. before.
Well, and I will say, when we drove around LA the next day,
mm-hmm.
that's all anyone was talking about was the Roadster and the semi truck.
Like, right.
this got into the mainstream news. It really captured people's imaginations.
Right.
I do want to disagree a little bit. You said that you think the Roadster is bigger news, or, you know, it's going to impact the world more than the semi truck. Semi trucks are ubiquitous. They are everywhere.
Oh,
and
of
I
course.
Think that the number of lives that are going to be saved, the number of, you know, the amount of emissions that are going to be saved.
I'm just talking culturally here. I'm talking about, you know, going forward,
I disagree
it's going to change the way people think.
I totally agree with that. But culturally also, the number one job in America right now is truck driving.
That's true.
And I think that this truck, although it will be driven by humans for a while, is going to evolve to be a truck that's autonomously driven. And that's going to have a huge cultural impact.
Mm-hmm.
That is why what happened the other night was mind-blowing in terms of blowing your brain into a different dimension, mm-hmm. because it has disrupted two or three or four industries all in one night.
We're not even talking about rail. I mean, he basically said that it's cheaper than rail.
Yeah, now. Being able to put trucks in a convoy, bye-bye rail.
Yeah, that's, I mean, whoa.
Because rail, although it's great in many aspects, it still only has limited routes. And
right.
you have to bring stuff to the rail, mm-hmm. whereas trucks can go anywhere. It was a mind-blowing night for us, and we did our damnedest to bring it to you live stream. We had thousands of you view it. Thank you so much for your awesome comments.
Mm-hmm.
I was just in some other dimension the entire night.
As was I. Now, we do have some footage that you have not seen from that night. Actually,
oh, yeah.
quite a bit of footage. If you want to, we're going to be releasing some interior footage of the Roadster and
the semi. I got in there.
And if you want to see it, you head over to our Patreon, and it will be a Patreon-exclusive video.
Wow.
So to our Patreon supporters, this is a thank you to you, because without you guys, we would not have been at that event. So
that's right.
We want to bring you something special home. We couldn't all get you trinkets from the Santa Monica Pier. It would have been too expensive, and it wouldn't have fit in our bags. We only brought two bags, so sorry. But we hope that this will be a little token of our gratitude. So thank you so much, Patreons. You guys rock. Everyone else, you also rock. But head over to Patreon and show your support.
Yeah, you want to see what that baby looks like inside.
All right, thank you so much for watching this episode of In Depth. See
now
you tomorrow
know.
For
Tesla Time News.